Hi guys, this is Mallikarjun. Today I am with one more exciting topic on database drop or database delete. So in my previous topic I covered on database creation, Oracle Home creation, listener and TNS, and all the configuration part I have covered, and with that we have done with the installation and configuration part. So now coming to the new topic, so drop database or delete database. So once you create your database, how to decommission that database, or how to drop that database, or how to delete that database. So there are many ways to do this activity. So quickly I will open my notepad. Okay, so drop database, you can do it either GUI method or manual method. Okay, so as you see my screen here, in GUI method, either you can launch DBCA and then select drop option to drop the database, or you can log into OEM or grid control and then you can delete it. So this OEM or grid control has only limitation to delete instances, not the databases. So in case of rack, I'm talking about this delete instance in case of rack. So coming to manual method, either you can put your database in restrict mode and then drop the database, or the other method is just shut down the database and manually delete all the data files, configuration files and control files and data logs, whatever related to that database. So which is highly not recommended. So it is just also one of the way I'm just wanted to put it down here. So I will show you GUI method quickly, and and then quickly I'll jump into manual method of drop, because I'm very much interested in dropping database using manual method rather than going with the GUI method. So drop database possibilities in manual method, right? So I said connect database in mount restrict mode and drop the database. So if your database in open mode, the drop database is not possible. Your database is just mount mode and drop database is not possible. If your database is in mounted with exclusive mode, drop database is not possible. And the last option, if the database is mount with restricted mode, then your drop database option is possible. So I will show you all these options. Let's get started with the practical part. Okay, so I will just verify my database. Okay, DevDB is my database. I'll just try to log into the database. Okay, it is Dev database, DevDB, and it is in open mode, read write. So I'll just open my alert log. Then I already opened one more window. I'll just tell my alert log. Okay, so what I'll do, as per my note, I'll just launch DBCA first, and then I'll show you that drop database option. For that, I connected to GUI mode here. I am already into my Oracle DB Home bin directory. Here you can see here you go, DBCA. So I'm just going to launch DBCA, then you will get a GUI mode. See, here you go, GUI mode has came up. Few more seconds, it will be ready. Yep, here you go. I'll click on next, and each one should know all these options. Create database is for creation of new database. Configure database option is for existing database. You can do some configuration changes in that database. And delete database is the option. You can actually drop the database. And manage template is just to create a template from existing database. Okay, I'll select with the delete database option and I'll proceed further. And then you will see all the list of databases here. If you are running 3-4 databases, all 3-4 databases will be listed out here, and you have to choose your database, appropriate database which you want to drop it, and then just click on finish. So it's going to drop the database. So So this is pretty simple and very, you know, quick. I'm not going to do it right now here because I'm interested in manual method of dropping. So I'll just close it. So this is how, you know, you need to drop the database using DBCA. Okay, so coming back to other method, OEM, I said, right? OEM or grid control. So this is 11g standalone database. So I will log into my OEM. So this is my OEM URL. So I'm trying to connect as a sys user. Sorry for these alerts. Okay, I logged into OEM. So then I'll go to server. Okay, here you go, right? Change database. No, add instance or delete instance. So as you see my comment section here, OEM or grid control, only instance delete. So it means if your database is a RAC database, real application cluster, if you want to add or delete the instance, you can do it via OEM or via grid control. So if I click also, it will fail because it's not a RAC instance. See, you see the error message, right? This is not a cluster database. Add instance or delete instance option can be performed only for cluster databases. So I just wanted to show this is also one of the way you can drop or delete the instance, not the database. Okay, coming to manual method. Manual method, I again mentioned two ways. One is connect to database in mount restrict mode and drop the database. I'm very much interested in this point, so I will explain all these options. So other way, I'll just cover it in words. If you read this sentence, shut down database and manually delete all the instances related or database related control files, redo log file, data file, p file, you know, everything, you know, whatever it is related to that database, you can delete it. So this is not recommended, but it's also one of the way I just wanted to mention here. Okay, now I'll go back to actual topic for the session is deleting or dropping a database using a manual method in a mount mode with a restrict option. So I already covered drop is possibilities only if you mount your database with a restricted, and rest other options, open mode or mount exclusive mode, it is not possible. So I'll just cover it. Okay, my alert log is opened here and my database is read write mode here. I'm going to drop database. It is in read write open mode, and if you fire this command, it says database must be mounted in exclusive mode. So it's not possible. So what I'll do, shut immediate. So it gave a message, database should be mounted in exclusive. So it doesn't mean that you have to mount your databases in exclusive mode. So I'll show you that. Startup mount exclusive. Your database, you started mount with exclusive mode, and then I'll fire the drop database command. Again, it says operations requires database in restricted mode, right? So what I'll do shut immediate, and then I will start database only in mount mode, and then let's see what happens, whether I'm able to drop the database or not. These two options got failed, and third option, just to start database in mount mode and fire the drop database command. See, again it's not possible. So I will again shut it down. Third option also failed. And then now I will fire the fourth option. I'll start the database in mount and in restrict. Now your database in mount mode and with restricted mode. Now I'm going to drop the database. It is actually going to be successful. Here you go. All see, deleted all the Oracle managed files, right? So you can see this alert log messages. setting down archive process deleted, and your job completed, right? So the conclusion is the manual method operation is you have to put your database in mount mode with restrict option, then only your drop database command is going to be successful. Thank you.